Hello everyone, in today's tutorial, we'll see how to add a tattoo to an image using Adobe Photoshop. Alright, fantastic, so let's get to it. Alright, so I will go ahead and open Adobe Photoshop, and then I will take the image I will be using and open it in here. Alright, now the first thing that I need to do is to save this image as a displacement file. So I will duplicate it in a new tab by going to image and choose duplicate. And I will name it displacement. I will press OK. As you can see, this will create a copy of this image but in a new tab. Alright, now we'll desaturate it. So I will go to image, adjustment, and choose desaturate, or you can press the shortcut shift Ctrl U on your keyboard. Alright, now we'll apply a level adjustment on it to darken it. So we'll go back to image, adjustment, and I will choose levels. I will darken the midtones in here, just right there, and I will increase the white a little bit from here, and I will press OK. Alright, now we'll apply a Gaussian blur on it, because displacement map give you a better result with a blur. So we'll go to filter, and I will go to blur, and I will choose Gaussian blur in here. I will put 5 pixels radius in here, and I will press OK. Now we need to save it, so we'll go to file and choose save as. I will make sure that it will be saved as a PSD format in here. It has to be a PSD in order for the displacement to work. And I will click save in here. Alright, I can close this now. Now I will grab the tattoo that I will be using. I will take it and open it in a new tab. And since it's an EPS file, this dialog box will open. So I will choose RGB in the mode in here. And I will press OK. Alright, now I want to get rid of this white that I have in here, so we'll have only black lines tattoo. So I will go to the channels right here, and then I will hold Ctrl on my keyboard, and I will one click on this RGB channel to make a selection of the white alone. Now I will go back to the layers panel, and I will hit delete. I will press Ctrl D to deselect. Alright, now we'll take it to the other tab using my move tool. And then I will right click and choose convert to smart object. I will name it dragon tattoo. Now I will press Ctrl T to make it smaller, and I will replace the tattoo to fit on the arm. I will press enter to commit the change. Alright, now it's time to apply the displacement file that I created earlier. So I will go to filter, distort, and I will choose displace. I will keep the horizontal and vertical scale 10. However, feel free to try out different values depending on the image you'll be using. Stretch to fit and repeat edges pixel are both selected, and I will click OK. And this will take me to load the displacement file I created. So I will select it, and then I will click open. And now it's applied. Alright, now we'll change the blending mode to multiply. Next, I will add a bit of noise to the tattoo to make it more realistic. So I will go back to filter again. I will go down to noise, add noise. I will put 3% in the amount, uniform in the distribution, and monochromatic is unchecked. I will press OK. And then I will go to the add noise blending options in here, and I will double click on it. I will change the blending mode to linear dodge add, and I will click OK. As you can see, this makes it a bit more realistic. Alright, now we'll double click on the dragon tattoo layer to open the layer style dialog. And then I will go to the blend if option down here, and right here in the highlights of the underlying layer slider, I will hold alt on my keyboard to take only the half of this slider and put it just around here. As you can see, the tattoo is now blended with the highlights. Alright, now we select the outer glow. I will choose a red color, and I will change the blending mode to linear burn. I will make the opacity 50%, and the size 2 pixel. And I will change the range to 100%. I will click OK. Alright, now we need to remove this part of the tattoo in here. So I will apply a layer mask on the tattoo layer by one click on this layer mask icon. And I will select the brush tool with the black as my foreground color. I will start layering this part of the tattoo in here. Alright, just like this. As you can see, this is before and this is after. Alright, so I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and wait for more tutorials to come. And thank you for watching. Have a nice day.